time I'd be ready. Oh, no bed for me tonight. Oh, how dreadful and dreary a prospect. Oh. Are you just the spirit of Christmas is yet to come? Are you about to show me the things that will happen? Will you not speak to me? Oh, I dread you more than I dread any other spirit. Very well. Show me what you will and I will try and bear it.
Not a threadbare place. It's the best he had, and a fine one too. They would have wasted it if it wasn't for me.
And what would you call wasting it, huh?
Put it on him to be buried in, to be sure. Somebody was fool enough to do it. I took it off him again. One of his old ones had been put it up for the worms, and he isn't likely to look any uglier than this one.
I suppose it'll be a cheap funeral, too, huh? Can't imagine what you've torn out.
If there's anyone there at all,
merciful heavens! Have these creatures any heart, any feelings? Will anyone mourn my passing? This can't be the pathetic legacy of all my work, my life!
Missus, it'll be all right.
It's too late.
But it's not too late. The bailiffs weren't called in. When Mr. Spence took him, he couldn't keep up with his debtors' records. And now Joe Skinfint is gone. I can't imagine whoever takes over the debt would press you like he did. You're sure to come to some arrangement and get your husband back on his feet again.
And I'm telling you, it's too late. It's too late for me, for my little ones, and for my poor dead husband who lies cold in a pauper's grave. My poor Tom did his best, but he couldn't weather the storm. He tried, God help him, he tried. But my Tom is gone, and nothing is going to bring him back to me.
I'm truly sorry for your loss, Missus.
You are a good man, sir. And I thank you for coming by to tell me. But your sorrow, it won't pay the rent, nor put food on the table for my hungry children. What pittance my son can bring home, it's not enough to keep us from the workhouse now. There is nowhere else for us to go.
This is not fair, Spirit. Am I to be held for a woman's misfortune? Am I to be held? What quantum is this? Who are you?
Do you not know me?
So how would I know you?
I'm the ghost of the child you once were.
I grew up. I had to grow up.
I'm the ghost of the child you chose not to see. The child whose life was not your business.
I did not have children. Other people's offspring were not my responsibility.
Your debtors whom you pressed had children. Your employees whom you tyrannized had children. Your own flesh and blood. Your sister had a child. Your nephew.
My nephew stole the life of my sister. She was the one person, the only person whose affection for me was constant.
Her affection for you didn't die with her. The seed of her love lay in her son. You had just given him a chance.
I didn't give a jot for his money or want any part of it.
He could only see in others what was in himself. Greed and avarice. He couldn't understand that your interest was driven by kindness. That you might have given him some comfort or peace in his last days. He couldn't see that someone could live a modest, happy life and not want more.
I swore on my mother's memory that I would do my best. his all. When she died, he lost her. We both lost her. And it seems with her death, we lost each other too. Oh, Alice, what a waste. What a waste.
I see it all now, but don't you understand how hard it was for me to forgive him?
Forgive him?
Take it back from me. She was the one person in this world whose love for me was constant.
Your nephew took nothing from you but only tried to give. Your bitter heart blinded you to any chance of seeing that the spirit of your sister was alive in him.
Oh, Fen. She was the one person who truly knew me and loved me for what I was, despite everything. Despite my father's disappointment in me. She was the one person who truly loved me for what I was, but I could not protect her. I could not protect her.
Fan loved you as you were. Would she have loved you became? Don't you see that she left your son and you rejected him?
Oh, Fan.
But see, someone else comes.
I don't know what we're doing here, Robert. After everything that happened?
I can't say for certain myself, Caddy, but I know that it's the right thing to do.
Oh, I know that there's respect in all of that and goes a long way on occasions like these. But even if you can find it in your heart while it's broken and smashed to smithereens to be so forgiving, I'm afraid I'd draw the line at your Mr. Scrooge. Think of our poor Jim. Gone.
Now, Caddy, please. Please, let's not dwell. I don't think I could bear it.
I know, Robert, I'm sorry. But I can't help but thinking that if it wasn't for that old skinflint, our Tim might be at home by the fire this Christmas. And then to let you go. After all the years you were with him without even knowing why you were late those last couple of times. You were always in work before him. Not even knowing that it was your own son's funeral that kept you.
Like I've told you, I didn't get the opportunity to explain. The office was very busy at the time, and you know how he was about business.
Would he even have let you explain if it wasn't busy? He never listened to you before. Mr. Scrooge and his business is business and timekeeping. Well, look where his business and timekeeping have gone now.
Hush. Hush, love, please. Mr. Scrooge is a man of business, and a man of his stature cannot be seen to entertain everyone's personal concerns. It's the way of the world of business.
And the world of business must be a cold and unfeeling place. Robert, there are men of business who have not forgotten what it's like to be kind and decent.
Mr. Scrooge taught me all I know about business, and I have to be grateful for that.
Mr. Scrooge taught you nothing! Don't you know values that you already didn't possess? A good, kind, hard-working, generous man like you. Perhaps if he had learned a few lessons from you, things might have been different.
Look, I'm sure Mr. Scrooge had his troubles, Caddy. Think now. Maybe things will take a turn for the better. You heard young Mr. Fred there, promising to give me a reference and to help me seek new employment. What a fine young gentleman he is. That'll make all the difference, Caddy. I'm sure it will.
Look at the difference, Robert. It's not going to bring our Tim back. Our family will never be the same again.
My Kirk, that woman, the boy.
We have seen but a few glimpses of what the future holds. There are many more dark and sorry stories unfolding as a result of your willful blindness. This spirit can take you on into more shadows of events to come, where you will see only more darkness for your kind of heart.
No, please, I cannot bear it. But is the future something? Are these the things, are the shadows, are the things that will be? Or are they the shadows of the things that may be only? And these horrible things, they have yet to happen, isn't that true? They don't have to happen, isn't that true? Can't the future be changed?
Well, will come. Eventful and fold in the future as you've seen their shadows tonight. If
I leave the path that you have shown me, then I can stop what you have shown me from happening. Isn't that true?
No future is absolutely certain, but the present is in your power's reach. Think on that forever, sleepy now.
No, no, please don't go, please don't go. Don't leave me with that dreadful silent presence. No, 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 Spirit, please, please, I cannot bear it. Please, please, I have no hope. I'm not the man I was. Please, please, give me time to undo the wrongs that I have done. Please, if you don't. I will keep Christmas in my heart. I've been striving to keep it all here. I've learned what the spirits will teach me. Oh, please, spirit, hear me, please, please.
The portrait on the next street, the one at the corner.
I should hope so.
Oh, good, good, good. Now, do you know, have they sold the prize stocking that was hanging in the window?
You mean the...
Not the small one now, the big one, the expensive one.
It's there, all right?
Oh, excellent. Go and buy it.
Okay. What's the idea? Are you trying to...
No, I mean it. Go and buy it. And when you've done, get back here in 5 minutes and tell him to send it to number 42 Primrose Lane. Bob Cratchit, 42 Primrose Lane. And when you've done, get back here in 5 minutes, and if you're back in time, I'll give you a shilling.
And what about paying for the turkey?
Oh, tell him Mr. Scrooge sent you.
Mr. Scrooge? They'll never believe
that. Hey, the little one, not the big one, right? Not the little one.
Oh, Bob Cratchit, come sailing in. We saw two ships come sailing in.
Oh, my dear sir, pray, gentlemen, listen.
Well?
Well?
Mr. Scrooge, I believe.
Oh, Scrooge and Marley.
Yes. How do you do? I hope you were successful in your collection yesterday. It was most generous of you. A happy Christmas to you both.
It is Mr. Scrooge, isn't it?
Oh, Scrooge and Marley.
Yes, that is my demon, and I fear it may not be very pleasant to you both.
Well.
I pray, may I beg your forgiveness? And yours, sir?
Yes, of course.
And if I may be allowed to make a contribution to your collection.
Lord, bless me. He wishes to donate.
Mr. Scrooge, are you serious?
Oh, yes, please, if you please.
It seems such a large sum.
It is such a large sum.
Oh, no, and not a farthing more. You see, a great many back payments are included.
Mr. Scrooge, I don't know what to say to such generosity.
Oh, please, say nothing. And another thing, gentlemen. I wish to remain anonymous.
Yes, of course, if you wish us.
I do.
Christmas for you, sir.
Oh, we're much obliged to you, sir.
I pray, come and see me someday.
Oh, with the greatest of pleasure.
Will you come and see me too?
Oh, will, sir.
Thank you, gentlemen, thank you. And now I must be off.
Happy Christmas to you, sir.
And many happy returns.
Happy New Year.
And another thing, gentlemen. I wish to remain anonymous.
Mum's the word. Well, who would have thought?
Mr. Scrooge, of all people.
Shall we see how much we've collected?
Oh, let's.
What do you make it?
Well, I make it.
So do I.
And with Mr. Scrooge's contribution, it will be.
So it will.
We must get this list published immediately.
Yes, except for Mr. Scrooge. He wishes to remain anonymous.
But that hardly seems fair. Mr. Scrooge has given the most.
Yes, Mr. Scrooge has given the most. We've been collecting, so to speak, we've raised a lot of money. We're going to give the poor a week of flowing milk and honey. Mr. Scrooge has given the most. Mr. Scrooge has given the most. Mr. Scrooge has given the most. He's given...
Charming wife of yours. Please give her my kindest regards.
I must be dreaming.
No. It is me who has been dreaming. Oh, here. Pray, accept a cigar.
That must have been a wonderful dream to put you in this humor.
It was. Here, have another cigar.
Thank you.
Now, you can do something for me.
Oh, what?
You can invite me to dinner tonight.
Come to dinner tonight.
I accept.
Oh,
brilliant. Did you get the turkey?
Yes.
And are they sending it to the address I gave you?
Yes.
And it's the big one?
Yes.
Yes, wonderful boy, wonderful boy.
Yes, I'll start in 5 minutes. What about me shilling?
Shilling?
Yes, you promised me a shilling.
I'm not going to give you a shilling, boy.
No?
No. I'm going to give you a half a crown.
Sure you're feeling all right.
Oh, Lord, capital, my boy, capital. Oh, here, before I forget, here, pray. Get that delightful wife of yours something for Christmas.
Delightful wife? But you've never even met her.
Well, sure, she must be delightful. You married her, didn't you?
Yes, I did. Hey, uncle, why not come back tonight and meet her?
Oh, I haven't time. I'm off to see Bob Cratchit.
Cratchit? You're not going to make him work today, uncle, are you?
Don't be preposterous. Today is Christmas Day. Nobody works on Christmas Day.
Uncle.
Are you alone?
I am, sir. A Merry Christmas to you, sir. My family are at Mass, will be home shortly.
Merry Christmas to you, too. Would you mind if I waited for your father's return? I have some business with him.
I would, sir. I think it's a pretty chilly day, so you'd better not be standing here in the cold hall. It's much more pleasant than here by the fire. It's an odd day to be doing business, isn't it? Oh, I hope your business is a happy one.
It is indeed. Indeed it is. May I? Do you not know me?
I don't think so, sir. Have we met?
No, we haven't met. But I hope to get to know you, and that your mother and father will permit me to get to know you better. You must be Tiny Tim.
Why, that isn't my name, sir. And if you're a friend of my father, I'm sure you'll get to know each other.
Oh, yes, I hope so indeed. And I hope to be a good friend to all your family. Now, if you're the Tim that I have heard of, then I hear you're quite the adventurer.
Well, not really, but I suppose I am my way. I do a kind of travelling on my head.
I think. Where do you travel to?
Oh, lots of places. I can go anywhere. The North Pole, the sea, the desert. Uh-huh. It all depends on the stories I hear and what I'm reading.
Oh, I think I was a little like you when I was your age. When I was a boy, I used to do a fair bit of travelling by myself, especially when I was lonely or I felt alone. But I did have a couple of trusted companions who would come with me.
And who are they?
Oh, one was called Ali Baba. Do you know him?
Of course, Ali Baba and 14 Thieves. What a good idea to have fun on your travels. And the other?
The other? Oh, well, the other's one's name was Robinson Crusoe. Do you know him?
I don't know of him. Who is he?
Oh, no. That's an example of a resourceful man. Huh? Oh, he's a great man to go on an adventure with.
I'm sorry we couldn't stay for the rest of the parents, Robert. Do you know I need to give you 2 minutes on?
We were only gone for an hour and the door was ajar. Mrs. Murphy would have heard if he needed
them. At least Martha and the chicks got to hear them.
Mr. Scrooge!
Oh, Mr. Scrooge!
Oh, Mother,
God,
this one is just telling me the most wonderful story about a man who was in
Mr. Cratchit, please forgive me. Mrs. Cratchit, for I must assume that is your name. Your son was kind enough to permit me to wait inside in the cold. I hope you can forgive me taking the liberty.
Mr. Scrooge, you said I could have the day off because it's Christmas Day.
Indeed I did, Cratchit. Indeed I did. But
what, sir?
I've been going through my accounts book, Cratchit, and...
Is there something wrong, sir?
Yes, there is something wrong, Cratchit. There is something wrong indeed.
What's wrong, sir?
Well, you see, Cratchit, I've been paying you every week, and it can't go on.
What can't go on, sir?
So I have decided to... raise your salary immediately! Double it!
Santa today! And Merry Christmas to you, Cratchit, and merrier Christmas than I have given you in many a long year.
Oh, Mr. Scrooge, please. A glass for Mr. Scrooge.
May I be seated?
Yes, of course.
We can discuss how best to help your family. Oh, thank you, Mrs. Cratchit, thank you. And here's to the best of season to all of your family. To you all, and God bless you.
God bless us, everyone. I want to get off.
Oh, no, Tim, wait.
No, now.
Come sit next to me.
Yes, of course. Mr. Scrooge, will you join us for dinner?
Oh, I would love to. And Cratchit, we must have more fires like this in the office.
Oh, Mrs. Scrooge, yes. I'd like to thank you so much.
Oh, please, don't mention it.
It's Christmas today. They were singing carols this morning. Oh. Do you know any carols?
Oh, no. I did know one many, many years ago.
Please sing it.
Oh, I could not sing. I haven't sung in years.
Please sing a carol.
Well, okay, but you're going to have to help me. My old voice isn't great. joy to the world. Joy to the world, the Lord is come. Let earth receive her King. Let every heart prepare his room. And heaven and nature sing, and heaven and nature sing.
Especially to work with a group here in front of us, a group of our youngest members, and I think the future of Blue Hat is in very safe. When we started on this venture, we decided we would do something for the winter months. Okay, so we went off in two different tangents. We decided we'd do Christmas carol, and then there were people wanted to go on the one-act circuit, and that means travelling around the country, doing festivals. And last weekend in Ballina, Blue Hat Productions won the All-Ireland Drama Festival for 2022 and are All-Ireland champions. Tonight to have some of the cast and our director with us. But before I'm going to introduce you to him, four of the team that went to Ballina are actually in the cast here tonight. And that is Caroline. Busy week. Darren. And at the back here, and before we introduce the cast and director themselves, there are two little things I want to say to you. It's a fabulous play. It is a real little gem. And we'll put that on here on the 28th and 29th of December, between Christmas and the New Year, when we'll be looking for something to do. And we would invite you here with the parish, the parish, and the dog's life. So that's the 28th and 29th, and put it near the early, and I will guarantee you a night of entertainment. The other things I just want to thank the larger group here for what they have done. There is a stage manager here, side stage, and she is she just makes it all happen. Like 29 scene changes, and Mary just makes it seem like it just happens. It doesn't. Right, back to Mary. Then we have our lighting and sound guy, Nailis, and Michael in the box there, and again, they just create all the moods and effects just to take us to different places, and it was a real job of work, and they just made it look so seamless. So, finally, a front of house, the people who kind of made it all happen in the door and made all of those things kind of happen for us. But during this weekend, we have had a group here assisting us, and that is Feroica. They had a cake sale on Saturday and made €1,300 for cancer research. They have had a shop here during the weekend where they are putting the money towards Blarney Meals and Wheels, and they are our youth, and they are just so fabulous in terms of what they do and bring to the community, and we want to thank Feroica. Six in the crew, and most of them sit in front of the page to me to get their hair done, right? And she has just the master's touch. She just turns them all out. She is just brilliant. And we want to acknowledge Alicia's work here. Without further ado, we should ask out the director.
Sincerely like to thank Trish and Paul for their absolutely outstanding direction, motivation, kindness, perseverance, patience to us. When he came and said we're going to do a Christmas carol 2 weeks before Christmas with 29 scene changes and 26 people, we nearly died. But I think it worked, so congratulations and thank you so much.
Is on in the Whitechurch in Barney on 30th, and look, it's a great night, and it's something different, and it's something local, and I think you enjoy it. So that's the gift of the gab on the 30th, 28th, and 29th of Dog's Life, and now, a big fanfare, we will invite out Sean Kelleher, the director of the Dog's Life.
So I'm here.
Vaughan got nominated for Best Actress, but along the way they have won a slew of awards and accolades, and well deserved. And now Sean's going to say a few words to them. It's going to take a while.
He loves the show. I don't think to say really, except we had an amazing journey. The lads, what can I say, they were amazing. You should wait to see this guy as a pup.
He's a nice little pup.
And Fifi, they were all amazing. They all did loads of work, and it was, we blew them away, but we won the freaking all out.
Sunday night, they win the All-Ireland. On Monday night, the night after, kind of 4 hours down the road, who turns up to do the lights for this show but Sean? And 10 minutes later, he's up in a lab or something, okay? And that's the kind of commitment, and that's what makes this club so great. And that, thanks to everyone, so look, that's what makes it. So we'll end up, and Bad Humbug is going to send us off on another final edition of...
I'll try and get it right this time.
Enjoy it.
Give me the right note there, like.
Cool at the start.
Right. Who's going to give me a key there?